Dear students, in our next lecture in the series of vibrational spectroscopy, we are dealing with IR spectra for simple molecules. Here we will see about two molecules, carbon dioxide and water molecule. Carbon dioxide is one which is having zero dipole moment, and water molecule is having a permanent dipole moment. In our previous lectures on molecular spectroscopy, we have seen about the dipole moments and how to find out the dipole moments and what are the properties of dipole moments that we have seen it there. So those some properties we will be using it over here in this lecture. Then we had seen about the rotational spectroscopy and the vibrational spectroscopy. We had also seen about the modes of vibrations or degrees of freedom. There are 3 degrees of freedom for motions, for translational motion along the 3 axes. Then we have 2 or 3 degrees of freedom for rotational motions, depending on whether the molecule is linear or non-linear respectively. Then other modes of vibrations are all vibrational modes of vibrations, or the degrees of freedom are the vibrational degrees of freedom. So in this lecture, we will see about the use of these fundamental techniques for the IR spectra of simple molecules like carbon dioxide and water molecules. So in this topic of IR spectra of simple molecules, we will deal with 2 different molecules. One is carbon dioxide and the other is water molecule. Let us first start with the carbon dioxide molecule. This carbon dioxide molecule is a triatomic molecule. So it has 3 atoms associated with it, 1 carbon and 2 oxygen atoms. So our number of atoms n will be equal to 3. So total degrees of freedom, total degrees of freedom will be equal to 3n. So that will be given as 3 into 3. So it will be 9 degrees of freedom are associated with this particular molecule. Then we have the geometry of the molecule. Is linear, as carbon dioxide can be written as oxygen bonded to carbon, bonded to oxygen. So carbon is bonded to 2 oxygen via double bonds, and so it becomes a linear structure. So it has a linear structure with a bond angle of 180 degrees. Then we have the number of vibrational modes of as it is a linear, so it is given as 3n minus 5. 5 here, 3 is for translational motion and 2 for rotational motion, as it is linear. So 2 rotational motions are there, 2 degrees of rotational motion. So that can be minus, or that can be subtracted from the total degrees of freedom. So it will be 9 minus 5 will be equal to 4 degrees of freedom it has. Similarly, the dipole moment of this molecule, as it is linear and it has both the bonds, bond moments are cancelling each other. So it has a 0 dipole moment. So its dipole moment is 0. So mu will be equal to 0 for this. So now with this detail, we can see the different modes of vibrations. There are total 4 modes of vibrations, 2 stretching modes of vibrations, and 2 bending modes of vibrations are there. We have to see which of them are IR active and which of them are IR inactive. As we have, for condition for obtaining an IR spectra is different from the condition for obtaining a rotational spectra. Conditions for rotational spectra was that the molecule must possess a dipole moment. Molecule must possess a dipole moment, then only it will be microwave active and a rotational spectrum will be obtained for that particular molecule. as carbon dioxide is having zero dipole moment, so rotationally it is inactive. Rotational spectroscopy, it is inactive in rotational spectroscopy. But for IR spectra, the condition is that the molecule must change its dipole moment while vibrating. During vibrational motion, its dipole moment must change. It may have zero overall dipole moment at equilibrium position, but during vibrational motion, if there is a change in dipole moment, then it will be active. Then that particular mode of vibration will be active. For a molecule which is having non-zero dipole moment, or a molecule which is having permanent dipole moment, for that all modes of vibrations are IR active. But for a molecule such as carbon dioxide, which has a zero dipole moment, few of the vibrational motions will be IR active and few will be inactive. We will see each one of them, of the four vibrational motions, how are they, and which of them are IR active and which of them are IR inactive modes of vibration. Let us see first the stretching modes of vibrations. There are two stretching modes of vibrations for this. One is symmetric stretching. And another one is asymmetric stretching. For symmetric stretching, we have, if this is our normal carbon dioxide molecule, when it is undergoing a compression, both the oxygens will be coming together towards carbon, and when it is undergoing stretching, this can be shown with one single bond also, a single line also, bond will always be two, but a single line also can be shown with this. So this is our expansion and this is our compression as compared to the equilibrium position. Now when we see both of this, the bond moments are exactly opposite and equal. They are equal and opposite in during the expansion as well during the compression. They are both equal and opposite. So overall, during the stretching mode of vibration, the new or the dipole moment always remains zero. The dipole moment always remains zero for symmetric stretching mode of vibration for carbon dioxide. Hence, symmetric stretching is IR inactive. Hence, symmetric stretching is IR inactive, and we will not be observing a peak corresponding to symmetric stretching in IR spectrum. So, this symmetric stretching becomes an IR inactive mode of vibration. What happens for IR? For the asymmetric stretching, that we will see it in during the asymmetric stretching, what happens is, if this is our normal equilibrium position, then when it is having an asymmetric stretching, one of the oxygen will be coming closer, the other oxygen will be moving further away. Similarly, for the other side, it will be happening in this particular way. So during this motions, what happens is, at the equilibrium position, the bond moments are equal and opposite, but during this particular motion, this side the bond moment is smaller, this side is bond moment is larger. The bond moment, if you remember, mu is equal to Q into L. Q is the charge separation and L is the distance between the two charges. So as the bond is stretched, the distance increases. As the bond is compressed, distance is decreasing. So L is decreasing and increasing, Q remains same. So mu will also decrease and increase. So there is a change in mu during the asymmetric stretching mode of vibration. Hence, as mu is changing during vibration, asymmetric stretching is IR active. Asymmetric stretching becomes IR active because during the vibrational mode, there is a change in dipole moment. The dipole moment is changing as the bond lengths are changing. यहाँ पर सिमेट्रिक स्ट्रेचिंग में भी बॉन्ड लेंथ चेंज हो रहे थे, लेकिन दोनों साइड के जो बॉन्ड्स थे उनका बॉन्ड लेंथ इक्वल रहता था, तो दोनों का जो बॉन्ड मोमेंट था वो इक्वल एंड ऑपोजिट होता था, इसकी वजह से वो दोनों कैंसिल कर देते थे एक दूसरे को. यहाँ पर क्या है कि एसिमेट्रिक स्ट्रेचिंग में एक बॉन्ड छोटा होता है, दूसरा बॉन्ड बड़ा होता है. सो जो छोटा वाला बॉन्ड है वो बड़े वाले को कम्प्लीटली नलीफाई नहीं करता है, थोड़ा सा नलीफाई करता है लेकिन थोड़ा सा बच जाता है. सो देयर इज अ नेट डायपोल मोमेंट प्रेजेंट ड्यूरिंग द स्ट्रेचिंग मोशंस. सो दैट इज व्हाई वी विल हैव म्यू इज चेंजिंग फ्रॉम यहाँ पे अगर हम देखेंगे तो ये फर्स्ट जो ऊपर वाला हमने दिखाया है इसमें नेट जो डायपोल मोमेंट होगा, दिस नेट डायपोल मोमेंट विल बी टूवर्ड्स दिस साइड, बिकॉज इस साइड में लेफ्ट साइड में ये बड़ा लंबा बॉन्ड है, longer bond है, bond length है, इसकी वजह से net dipole moment will be over this side. At equilibrium position, it will be having zero dipole moment. But lower diagram में जब आप आएंगे, lower mode of vibration का जो position होगा, उसमें यहाँ पर हमारा bond moment कम होगा और इस तरफ में हमारा bond moment ज्यादा होगा. So overall जो bond moment होगा, that will be of this side. So what is happening is कि ये जो हमारा लेफ्ट साइड में बॉन्ड मोमेंट था, डायपोल मोमेंट जो हमारा लेफ्ट साइड में था वो अभी राइट साइड में है. सो इट इज चेंजिंग द डायरेक्शन एज वेल एज इट इज गोइंग फ्रॉम लेफ्ट साइड टू राइट साइड वाया जीरो. सो इट इज चेंजिंग इट्स मैग्नीट्यूड ऑल्सो एंड चेंजिंग इट्स डायरेक्शन ऑल्सो. डायपोल मोमेंट इज अ वेक्टर क्वांटिटी, सो इट्स डायरेक्शन इज ऑल्सो इम्पॉर्टेंट एंड इट्स मैग्नीट्यूड इज ऑल्सो इम्पॉर्टेंट. यहाँ पे मैग्नीट्यूड भी चेंज हो रहा है और डायरेक्शन भी यहाँ पे चेंज हो रहे हैं. सो इट इज चेंजिंग इट्स डायपोल मोमेंट ड्यूरिंग द वाइब्रेशनल मोड एंड हेंस इट बिकम्स ए आईआर एक्टिव. देयर आर टू मोर वाइब्रेशनल मोड्स फॉर कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड, दोस टू आर 3 and 4, दैट इज बेंडिंग मोड्स ऑफ वाइब्रेशंस. Bending modes of vibrations mein we have this oxygens, they are moving towards this side or on the opposite side, on the other side, so that the bond angle here will be changing. Ye jo 180 degree bond angle hai ye change hota hai during the vibrations. So bond angle change hoga to we have the resultant bond mu r square is equal to mu 1 square plus mu 2 square plus 2 mu 1 mu 2 cos theta, where theta is this particular angle. So cos theta mein yahan pe agar cos 180 degree hoga to that will be minus 1, so it will be nullifying this, and so that is how it was nullifying and becoming zero. Lekin yahan pe agar hamara ye nahi hoga 180 degree change ho jayega to this particular value will change. Cos 0, so this particular value as it changes, it will be having a different mode will be coming up. So it will be giving us a non-zero dipole moment. As it gives us a non-zero dipole moment, so during the vibrational motion, bending motion, it will be changing. Similarly, for another bending mode of vibration will be coming if the oxygen atoms are coming towards us or going back of the plane of paper. Plane of paper से पीछे की तरफ में जा रहे हैं या हमारी तरफ आगे आ रहे हैं, तो फिर ये जो होगा वो एक दूसरा मोड ऑफ बेंडिंग मोड होगा. पहले बेंडिंग मोड में ऑक्सीजन ऊपर या नीचे की तरफ में मूव कर रहे थे, दूसरे इसमें ऑक्सीजन आगे पीछे की तरफ में मूव कर रही है. सो इट इज जस्ट कि अगर हमारा कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड हम एक्स एक्सिस पे लेते हैं तो पहले इसमें वो वाई एक्सिस में ऑक्सीजन मूव कर रहे थे और दूसरे इसमें वो जेड एक्सिस की तरफ में ऑक्सीजन मूव कर रहे हैं. सो इन दोनों मोड्स में बॉन्ड एंगल जो है वो चेंज होता है एंड बॉन्ड एंगल चेंज होने की वजह से उसका डायपोल मोमेंट भी चेंज होता है. एंड एज द डायपोल मोमेंट इज चेंजिंग द बेंडिंग मोड्स ऑफ वाइब्रेशंस आर IR active. The bending modes of vibrations are IR active. Means यहाँ पे जो हमारे चार हमारे जो vibrational modes थे, दो symmetric and दो bending. इसमें से symmetric stretching जो है वो हमारा IR inactive है. Asymmetric stretching is active and both the bending modes are active. So totally three vibrational modes are active, IR active. While one is IR inactive. This was for the carbon dioxide molecule, which was having zero dipole moment. Our second example is of water molecule. Water molecule, as we know, it is having a bending structure. And so it is having a non-zero dipole moment. As it is having a bent structure, so it is having a non-zero dipole moment. It is also a triatomic, two hydrogens and one oxygen are there. So this water molecule is type of molecule, we can say that it is a triatomic. Then number of or total number of degrees of freedom, total number of degrees of freedom is 3n, that is 9 over here as it is triatomic, so it will be 9. Then we have geometry for this, as it is having a bent structure, so its geometry is non-linear geometry. So number of vibrational modes will be (3n-6). Linear rehta to 3n-5, non-linear hai to 3n-6, because rotational motion mein non-linear molecule ke 3 number of vibrations hote hain, 3 number of rotational motions hote hain. So 3 translational and 3 rotational, total 6. So 3n-6 will be equal to 9-6 equals 3 modes of vibrations. Yahan pe hamare 3 modes of vibrations hote hain for water molecules. And its dipole moment is mu is non-zero dipole moment. As it is a non-zero dipole moment, इसके सारे ही vibrational modes IR active होंगे. For non-zero dipole moment, all modes of vibration, all modes of vibrations are IR active. ये आपको ध्यान में रखना है कि all modes of vibrations are IR active for a non-zero dipole moment. यहाँ पे जो हमारे तीन modes of vibrations हैं, those three are, one is a symmetric stretching, again in this symmetric stretching we will have if this is our equilibrium position, then this is the compressed mode, like this is our expanded mode. So, yahan par in all these there is a change in dipole moment that is happening, because इसका जो bond moment होगा that will be of this type, ये इस तरफ में होगा, यहाँ पर जो bond moment होगा that will be little larger, here it will be still further large, because the bond lengths are increasing, so bond moments बढ़ जाते हैं और उसकी वजह से जो augment करते हैं ये एक दूसरे को add करते हैं और addition में ये और भी बड़ा dipole moment बन जाएगा expanded structure में. Compressed structure में dipole moment छोटा होगा, expanded structure में dipole moment बड़ा होगा. So it is having dipole moment, there is a change in dipole moment is happening. Change in dipole moment during the motion is we can observe it. The second is asymmetric stretching. In asymmetric stretching, we have one of the hydrogens will get compressed, the other will get elongated. So in this case, what happens? ये इसका जो dipole moment होगा वो छोटा होगा, यहाँ पे dipole moment होगा वो बड़ा होगा, यहाँ पर smaller होगा और यहाँ पे this side will be smaller and this side will be larger. जबकि equilibrium position में ये दोनों the dipole moments, bond moments दोनों same होते हैं. So dipole moment will be changing its direction during this particular motion. तो यहाँ पे हमारा ये भी IR active होता है. And third that we have is bending mode of vibration. In this bending mode of vibration, what we have is oxygen attached to the two hydrogens. These hydrogens will be moving towards away from each other or towards each other, so that ये जो bond angle है, ये bond angle change होता है. Bond angle will be changing. This theta will be changing, and because of that, the dipole moment इसका change होता है during the motions. तो यहाँ पर dipole moments will be changing during the motion for this. So that can be easily done. Symmetric stretching जो होता है for water molecule that occurs at around 3651.7 per centimeter. That is vibrational frequency होता है उसका. Asymmetric stretching का है 3755.8 per centimeter, and for bending it is 1595 per centimeter. Bending के लिए कम energy लगती है, stretching, bond stretchings या compressions के लिए ज़्यादा energy लगती है. So हमेशा stretching modes of vibrations का energy ज़्यादा होता है और bending modes of vibrations का energy कम होता है. So this was for the water molecules. Same thing we can have it for carbon dioxide also. For carbon dioxide, the bending modes of vibration में जो frequency है, that frequency is 667.33 per centimeter for bending modes of vibration. दोनों के लिए same है. For asymmetric stretching, we have vibrational frequency as 1330 per centimeter for asymmetric stretching के लिए. Symmetric stretching के लिए जो कि IR inactive है, but its vibrational frequency is 2349 per centimeter. ये हम रामन में देख सकते हैं. That is in our next lecture we will see it about the Raman spectroscopy. There we can see the symmetric stretching mode of vibration for carbon dioxide also. For this we have it up till here. That is the simple molecules IR spectra. So we have finished with the IR spectroscopy or the vibrational spectroscopy with this. In the next lecture we will look into the Raman spectroscopy. That will be the last lecture for our molecular spectroscopy.